has come to our family. You remember our venerable house? Opulent and imperial, gazing proudly from its stoic perch above the moor. I lived all my years in that ancient, rumor-shadowed manor, fattened by decadence and luxury. And yet I began to tire of conventional extravagance. Singular, unsettling tales suggested the mansion itself was a gateway to some fabulous and unnameable power. With relic and ritual, I bent every effort towards the excavation and recovery of those long-buried secrets, exhausting what remained of our family fortune on swarthy workmen and sturdy shovels. At last, in the salt-soaked crags beneath the lowest foundations, we unearthed that damnable portal of antediluvian evil. Our every step unsettled the ancient earth, but we were in a realm of death and madness. In the end, I alone fled laughing and wailing through those blackened arcades of antiquity, until consciousness failed me. You remember our venerable house, opulent and imperial. It is a festering abomination. I beg you, return home, claim your birthright, and deliver our family from the ravenous, clutching shadows of the darkest dungeon.
You will arrive along the old road. It winds with a troubling, serpent-like suggestion through the corrupted countryside, leading only, I fear, to ever more tenebrous places. There is a sickness in the ancient, pitted cobbles of the old road, and on its writhing path, you will face viciousness, violence, and perhaps other damnably transcendent terrors. So steel yourself, and remember there can be no bravery without madness. The old road will take you to hell, but in that gaping abyss, we will find our redemption.
brigands have run of these lanes. Keep to the side path. The hamlet is just ahead. Dispatch this thug in brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival. Leave nothing unchecked. There is much to be found in forgotten places. An ambush. Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome. Concentration. Another life wasted in the pursuit of glory and gold. Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Brigands have run of these lanes. Keep to the side path. The hamlet is just ahead. Dispatch this thug in brutal fashion, that all may hear of your arrival. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. Leave nothing unchecked. There is much to be found in forgotten places. An ambush. Send these vermin a message. The rightful owner has returned, and their kind is no longer welcome. Welcome home, such as it is. This squalid hamlet, these corrupted lands, they are yours now, and you are bound to them. Women and men, soldiers and outlaws, fools and corpses. All will find their way to us now that the road is clear. Great heroes can be found even here. In the mud and rain. Most will end up here, covered in the poisoned earth, awaiting merciful oblivion. A mecca of madness and morbidity. Your work begins.
The cost of preparedness, measured now in gold, later in blood.
The fiends must be driven back. And what better place to begin than the seat of our noble line? Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage. Give them no quarter. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless.
Thank you.
As victories mount, so too will resistance. Devastating blow. A singular strike. The beast, the greater the glory. Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious killer. Packs laden with loot are often low on supplies. ancient traps lie in wait, unsprung and thirsting for blood. Glittering gold, trinkets and baubles, paid for in blood. If only treasure could staunch the flow of otherworldly corruption. Finding the stuff is only the first test. Now it must be carried home. The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it. As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves. This expedition at least promises success. These nightmarish creatures can be felled. They can be beaten. Machinations spring to life with a singular purpose. Wealth beyond measure, awarded to the brave and the foolhardy alike. Without tools of iron, you must rely on flesh and indefatigable purpose. More bones return to rest. Devils remanded to their abyss. There is a great horror beneath the manor. A crawling chaos that must be destroyed. This man understands that adversity and existence are one and the same. Fresh kegs, cards, and curtained rooms promise solace to the weary and broken alike. The cobwebs have been dusted, the pews set straight. The Abbey calls to the faithful. Strong drink, a game of chance, and companionship. The rush of life. pace out the halls of your lineage once familiar, now foreign. Assault cannot be left unanswered. Mortality clarified in a single strike. Dazed, reeling, about to break. As the fiend falls, a faint hope blossoms. Confidence surges as the enemy crumbles. Injury and despondence set the stage for heroism or cowardice. Gone, fiend. The bigger the beast, the greater the glory. Executed with impunity. As life ebbs, terrible vistas of emptiness reveal themselves. Perched at the very precipice of oblivion. A victory. Perhaps the turning point. Disadvantage. Give them no quarter. Prodigious size alone does not dissuade the sharpened blade. The way is lit. The path is clear. We require only the strength to follow it. Death waits for the slightest lapse in concentration. True test. Hold fast or expire. quickly the tide turns. The human mind, fragile, like a robin's egg. Fear and frailty finally claim their due. Survival is a tenuous proposition in this sprawling tomb.
A trifling victory, but a victory nonetheless. Even the cold stone seems bent on preventing passage. Soaks the soil, feeding the evil therein. Wounds to be tended, lessons to be learned. The poor caretaker. I fear his long-standing duties here have affected him.